Good morning, guys. Let's go through the Shop My Stash basket of the day and start with the complexion products. First of all, I don't think I'm going to spend too much time talking about the Auric Glow Last. I love this stuff. For foundation, I want to use my Double Wear Nude Foundation. I think I want to switch around between this one and my Pat McGrath one because they are pretty similar. This one is just slightly... Well, this one fits me better in terms of color. The Pat McGrath one is really light and I can only use it in like the really deep winter months when I'm super pale. But I really like the formula of this one as well, so I'd like to switch it up a little bit. For my concealer, I'm going to continue to use my Clarins Instant Concealer as usual. Then for bronzer, I actually picked out the Chanel Soleil Teint de Chanel bronzer because this stands in another drawer compared to my other bronzers and I kind of often forget to pull it out. Like, I will pull out my Fenty Cream one and my Milk one because I really like them, but I will forget this one because it's in another drawer, so I thought let's give it some love today. I'm sticking with cream products for my cheeks as well, or at least for my blush. I'm going to be using this Kiko cream blush, which is, I don't know, you guys, it was a limited edition from a few years ago. It's called Coral Vibes and I just absolutely love the packaging, and a combination of like the coral tones with the green jade packaging is absolutely beautiful. Then for my highlighter, a little bit of a throwback and a product that you know very well that I love so much. This is my Aurora Glow Kit from Anastasia Beverly Hills, which is going to serve actually a dual purpose for this Shop My Stash because I'm going to use one of my favorites, Eclipse, as a highlighter. I'm like super close to hitting pan on this one, but I've been close to hitting pan on it for like the last 2 years and I'm still trying to get to the bottom of that pan. And I'm also going to use the blue shade Orion as an inner corner highlight because the eyeshadow palette that I have chosen doesn't really have an inner corner highlight that I consider suitable for the look that I'm going for. So let's talk about the look that I'm going to be going for today. I recently filmed my makeup collection video and one of the things I realized is that I just don't give enough love to my Nabla single eyeshadows, which I have here. And when I designed this palette, I designed it so that the colors would go together a little bit in a color story so that I can create looks with them and not be like a jumbled mess, which I would usually do when I pick out single eyeshadows and then never touch them again. Still, I haven't really touched this eyeshadow palette in a really long time, so I figured let's pull it out for today. I want to do a look with this shade here, or like mostly centered around these two shades here. This is the shade Virgin Island, which is one of the special shades from Nabla, which I can never remember the name of. I want to call them Celestials, but I'm not sure. So I want to use this one, probably going to mix it in a little bit with the shade Alchemy because I like to mix these two shades, although Virgin Island is beautiful on its own and I absolutely love these like deep indigo blue. So we're going to be going for a really blue look today. The reason you're also seeing the chocolate bonbons in here is pretty simple. I need something to blend out my crease that is a little bit more neutral. So the only reason this eyeshadow palette is in this Shop My Stash video is because I want to use this shade through my crease and possibly this one as a brow bone highlight. Together, I'm going to take my Auric Glow Last. This is just going to be like a standard product in my little Shop My Stash videos, or like any of my videos, because I will just continue to use it until it's finished, honestly. I've already primed my lids and applied my brows, by the way, off camera, because that's just like way too fucking boring to do together. And the reason I wanted to film this in the end, even though I wasn't really planning on filming today, is that I finally decided to pull out my little self-made sextuplet of Nabla eyeshadows, which I have in like a little palette that you might have just seen in my makeup collection video. I showed that on camera and then I was beating myself up for never using it, and I thought, you know what, I'm just going to pull it out and use it in the Shop My Stash as soon as I can. And then all of a sudden I decided to wear a bunch of blue things today, so I thought, perfect, let's just do it. Next I'm taking my Instant Concealer from Clarins. Again, a product you have seen many, many times by now. Nothing new there. But yesterday I was watching, I don't know if you guys follow Alex Anel. She has really gained a lot of traction in the last couple of months. But she was doing this Dude series where she was basically talking about how different makeup techniques and different ways of applying, like different position of your makeup application, can make a huge difference in how you frame and shape your face. And a couple of days ago she kind of like posted like the ultimate finale to that series, because she did her whole face half with techniques that she doesn't really use on herself because she doesn't think they flatter her, and the rest of her face with techniques that she always uses because she thinks they flatter her face shape. And I thought it was a really interesting video. I'm going to take my Estée Lauder Double Wear Nude Foundation, which is a beautiful, very sheer coverage foundation. And I'm going to try to take the smallest amount possible. So anyway, I thought it was a really interesting video, and I thought the end result, I don't know, like even the part of her face that she thought was techniques that didn't suit her, I can agree with some of it, but like I personally really liked the way the blush looked on the side that she doesn't usually do on herself, because she said she normally brings up her blush a bit more upwards because she has pronounced cheekbones. And I feel like that is also a little bit the shape of my face, and I also don't really like heavily apply blush here on the apples of my cheeks, but to be honest with you, I didn't hate how it looked on her. And I think that I do something in between what she wouldn't do and what she would do. I feel like she applies her blush a little bit too much up here for my personal taste, but I also don't put it all the way here on my the apples of my cheeks. I kind of keep it concentrated in this general area, which you're going to see in a little bit. So did you guys see the video and what did you think of it? I'm going to powder my face with my Hourglass Mood Light powder, which I definitely have a pan on, and that pan is really motivating me to just keep using the powder until it's finished. So when I was watching her, I applied the nose contour. I thought, oh my goodness, I have a lot of like respect for her knowing her face shape so well, to such detail, such minute detail, that she knew exactly where to put the contour, like here and like here and like here. And I was like, oh my god, I would never have the patience to even like try to figure it out. I'm going to take my Chanel Soleil de Teint de Chanel bronzer and use that to warm up my face. Who the fuck has the time to do such extensive contouring? Like on the daily, I barely have time to do what I'm doing now. There is no fucking way in the whole wide world that I'm going to contour so precisely my whole face, and then I'm still going to apply a powder bronzer over top. Like, that's just never going to happen. I definitely have a lot of respect for Alex for showing that technique and showing how important it is to know your face, because that's a point that I often try to make over here, but more in the context of buying products that will suit you. She was doing it more in the context of placement of products and how a lot of people talk about, oh, you're not allowed to put blush on the apples of your cheeks, or you're not allowed to put bronzer in this way or that way, or you have to contour your nose in this particular way. No, there are no rules. You have to find out what works for your personal face shape, which is a message I feel like is so, so important, and like I'm super on board with it. But like, there's no fucking way ever that I'm going to go in such details in contouring my nose. So I thought that was really funny. I'm going to take my duo cream blush here from Kiko, an old limited edition collection, like I said, and I'm going to apply my blush. And I feel like so much more like conscious of where I'm applying my blush now that I have watched her video, but I feel like this is how I apply my blush. So I do indeed start the way that she does, which is more towards my cheekbones, and I bring it very lightly onto my actual like cheeks. I don't really bring it all the way here, because I think that fits more rounded faces a bit better than it would fit my face shape. And last but not least, I'm going to take my Aurora Glow Kit from Anastasia Beverly Hills, and I'm going to take the shade Eclipse and apply that here on the tops of my cheeks, right here to highlight. I still really, really like this shade of highlighter, and I don't really have anything to replace it once it's finished, but I think, contrary to what I always thought, which is that I would repurchase this glow kit if I ever ran out of Lyra and Eclipse, I now think I've come to the point where I don't think I'm going to do that. I'm going to start with my eyeshadow, and I'm going to go into the Chocolate Bonbons, like I said, only for this shade here. And the reason I am not going to be repurchasing the glow kit is Another lesson that I can share with you on purchasing makeup, which is, do not buy backups of your favorite products, especially if they're like color cosmetics, like I don't know, blushes, eyeshadow palettes, shit like this, even lipstick, because chances are very high that with the tempo that the industry is developing, someone is going to come out with something similar and better, and you're going to regret purchasing that backup because you're going to want the new shiny. And now for the fun part, we're going to go in my little Nabla palette over here, and the idea is I'm going to put this shade kind of like a smoky eye all over my lid, but a bit more concentrated here in the outer part of my eye, and then over top of that and glitter glue, I'm going to layer this shade and possibly apply the tiniest bit of this shade. I have done this mixing before and it looks really, really beautiful. So I'm going to start applying it very gently just here towards the lash line before I bring it up towards the crease. But it's such a beautiful shade. Oh my goodness, I just love it so much. And I am going to switch to a smaller blending type of brush in a second just to blend this shade out. I'm taking my, what is this one? Looks Defined Crease from Zoeva. And I'm going to start blending over here without bringing this shade too far in. Another lesson that you might have learned from Alex Anel, that if you bring the dark shade too much into your crease, you're going to create a more rounded eye shape. In my case, I don't want to do that because I feel like my eyes are already small and round, but I'm very happy and proud of myself that I've already learned that lesson all by myself. I was already not doing that for quite some years, bringing the dark color all the way in. And I'm going to use whatever is left on my brush and just kind of like bring that shade all the way in, like I said, for almost like a dark blue smoky eye. Okay, taking my glitter glue and applying that pretty much on like the inner part of the lid where I want to apply the metallic shimmer shades, starting inwards, bringing the glitter glue in. And I'm going to go into these two shades, which are part of their celestial formula, I want to say. This is the shade Virgin Island, and this is one of their most popular shades, is the shade Alchemy. I'm going to start with Virgin Island and apply that pretty much all over the lid. This shade is just so fucking beautiful. I might do some outer corner intensifying in a little bit, but for now I just want to take a lighter layer of Alchemy, like a really much lighter layer, and just start working that over top of that Virgin Island shade. And it's just going to give that Virgin Island shade a bit more dimension without really taking away from that blue. I'm going to apply the tiniest bit of that deep blue matte that we applied earlier just to intensify over here in the outer corner. And I'm going to make even more use of that Anastasia Glow Kit, and I'm going to apply the blue highlight as my inner corner highlight, because I don't really have a shade like that in my Nabla palette that will serve as an inner corner highlight. On my lower lash line, I'm once again going to apply the matte blue shade, but I'm going to concentrate that here in the outer third of the eye, not bringing it too much in. And as a final touch, I'm going to once again take the shade Virgin Island, but this time I'm going to wet my brush with a little bit of Fix Plus so this shade doesn't get up all in my eye, and I'm going to press it here in the inner part of my lower lash line. I'm going to stick with the blue shades, and I'm going to just apply a little bit of a blue liner in my waterline and tight line. This is just a Catrice one. And last but not least, let's do the lipstick, which, like I said, is Brunette Ambition from H&M. And that is all for this Shop My Stash video, you guys. I hope you enjoyed this super bright blue look. You got a bunch of blue going on. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!